person that is next to you, this is the day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be blessed in it. Hallelujah. Are we all excited? Are we all happy? Ritavile kaufela. Can you show me your happiness by shouting and screaming and making a joyful noise unto the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus. It is nice to be in the house of the Lord together. It is nice to come together under one shadow. The reason being that we want to worship our God and bless Him and thank Him for all the wonderful things and all the great things that He has done in our lives. We are what we are because of His grace and His mercy. We are alive today. It is because He has changed our lives. He has redeemed us and made us to be who we are and what we are today. Hallelujah. So we are going to start this service by worshiping Him, lifting our hands unto Him, opening our hearts unto Him, and believing that He is the only one that can change our life for the best. We are here to adore Him. We are here to bless Him. We are here to worship Him. Let us lift our hands. We are going to worship the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that You're my God. You're altogether loving. You're altogether worthy. You're all. wonderful, wonderful to me. Here I am. Praise Lord. Oh, here I am, here I am.
Father, we give you praise. Lord, we give you all the glory. Father, we adore your holy name. We thank you for this opportunity. Father, thank you for this time that you have given up to us. We are here before you, Heavenly Father, as your children. And we believe that the anointing of fire will be upon us tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, you have promised that, Heavenly Father, whenever we come together, you shall be there. Father, we will see by signs, we will see by wonders. Father, we will see by the perfection. And Heavenly Father, Father, I just love to give you the praise. I just love to give you the glory. I just love to worship your name. I just love to adore your holy name. I just love to bless you as the Lord and the God of my life. You are worthy, you are awesome, you are worthy, you are great. You are worthy, you are loving, you are worthy, you are wonderful. You are the only presence of this year, all knowing God. You are the Lord that is always there. You are the Lord that stays on the promises of his word. Whatever you say, Heavenly Father, come to pass in our midst. Heavenly Father, whatever you command, happens in our front. Father, when we are watching and when we are seeing, when we are looking, we give you the praise, Jesus. I give you the glory, Father. I give you the glory, Jehovah. I worship and I bless your holy name. I say, blessed be unto the name of the Most High God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for your hand upon our life. Thank you for thy mercy and thank you for thy grace. Thank you for all the wonderful and all the good things and all the great things that you are doing in our lives for the glory of the kingdom of the Lord. Father, I give you the praise. Father, I give you the glory. Blessed be unto the name of the Lord in the highest. We give you the praise, Jesus. I give you the glory, Father. I give you the glory, Jehovah. I bless your precious mighty name. Blessed be unto the name of the Lord. We give you the praise, Jesus. I give you the praise, Jehovah. I give you the glory, Father. Oh, we worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Father. We bless your name. We bless your mighty name. Blessed be unto the name of the Most High God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of the Almighty God. Thank you, Jehovah.
Maya waka uriye, uriye, uriye. Ah! for Jesus. Clap your hands, shout and scream for Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah to the name of the King. Hallelujah to the name of the Most High God. Clap your hands, shout and scream for Jesus. Yay! 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 We give you all the praise, Jesus. We give you all the glory. Oh, glory to the name of the Most High God. Glory to the name of the King. Hallelujah. 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 You know, there is a Zulu song that interests me so much. It says, Ngangena lapho kuthiwa, maungene khona uphumi, ngaphuma lapho kuthiwa, akuphunywa, akuphunywa. Hallelujah. I have entered into a place where everybody said nobody comes out when you went in there. And I went out of the place where somebody said nobody can even ever come out of this place. Hallelujah. Uyazi lento yenzekala makuyenzekala. You know why these type of things happen? It's when you trust in the Lord and trust in Him only and believe in Him only. Trials may come, tragedies may come, Christ may come. Hey, shoutings may come, but let me tell you, this God will never, never let you down. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Can you hear the shout and the screaming of the Arezi nation? Yay! Hey! Eric Lebutseng Tava. No, I do understand or Baba Ngwa about Vipulelo Yenaki Vulelang, but Kitalika Kita try. Let me tell you something. When you trust in God, when you believe in Him alone, and you trust in Him alone, He will never let you down. Never. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, trials and tragedies and everything may come in your life, but if you trust in this God, our God is a good God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Last 2 weeks, I heard one of our youth saying, we are the Arezi nation. So let me tell you, we are the Arezi nation. Hallelujah. Can you tell the person that is next to you, we are the Arezi nation? Do you want to see? Arezi. What is it that you want? Arezi. It's all we know one up. We are Dumeloba. Are we all excited? Hey, we are Tabaki Tabele Juangna. It's like a jump, I can jump and reach that other side. Hallelujah. I'm just going to welcome you as a mother of the house. Welcome to Charis Missionary Church. Ikhaya la mahlanya. Sihlanya kuqala kubaba sifike kumntwana omncane. Rechoma kupapa, li papa wana waya hafa, li tivi. Ufita maungwa nengo mbunyani, auna mutu yete rijuteji, auna ntwe urisaka moka ufela. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are going to dance for our Lord God Almighty in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we ready to shout and scream for the Lord? Are we ready to do it one more time for the Lord? Can we shout and we scream and we glorify the name of the Lord? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Yay! Glory to the name of the Lord! Can you tell somebody that is close to your ear, you are robbing? You are robbing. That's who. Waroba is changani. Waroba kaspedi. Can we shout and we scream, we ululate and we glorify the name of our God Almighty, the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yay. Yay. We are going to find a chorus. We'll be dancing, greeting each other. And as we'll be singing this chorus, I believe Apostle will be coming to the front to come and welcome us officially. Hallelujah. Marari Tavila. Are we excited? Are we happy? Akelim Poncheng Litavolal Najolokama Afrika or Elena Litavali Diajo. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to the name of the Lord. Yay. Aibo. Ehe. Yeah, you just show me a little bit that you're Africans. Just a little bit. Can you show me your excitement to show me that you are blessing your God in the name of Jesus? Yay! Yay! Hallelujah! Glory to Jesus. Yay! We are going to find a chorus. We'll be dancing. Aziabu, you're serious. Idea of Oyariku, which is happening. Today we will see all styles. Eh? Hallelujah. We are going to find the chorus. Apostle will be coming to the front in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Don't become sophisticated and complicated. Don't try to confuse yourself. We are in the house of the Lord. Amen. Eh? Are we all happy? Kaniti, kaniti. Umu Jehovah, efulimi nyango. Umu Jehovah, efulimi nyango. Angeko, ongafala.
Amen. Clap hands for yourself. You can see that. Thank you.
Do long fast, it's a man hands.
I'm seeing flags, hands, everything. I'm sure you're
not.
Let me hear your scream when you're sitting there.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Siyabonga.
I don't know where to start today, and because we are starting this conference, and then I'm expecting results. I know what my God can do. So God of charis want to bless all of you.
Charis,
that you are blessed. You just know. And whatever we'll be teaching here, go and practice at your church and see what God will do for you. I believe you are going to enjoy yourself there. God bless you.
Amen.
Clap hands for yourself. Thank you. So, open your Bible there. Remember our scripture and of Charis, which we are going to read tonight.
We'll start from there.
Titus 2:11. Let's go there. 2:11. This is a scripture we have that our Father gave us,
which
you fathers, you are still going to give your children. For the grace of God hath appeared, bringing salvation. Let me read it, Amplified Bible. It says, for the grace of God, his unmerited favor and blessings has come forward or appeared for the deliverance from sin and the eternal salvation of all mankind. As you can see that.
Amen.
And also in King James Version, if we can read there, he says what? He says, for the grace of God that has bringeth salvation has appeared to all men.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
If we can read here, it talks about the grace
has
appeared. And then, it's not what I want to talk about, but I want to start from there. The grace will appear where there is the glory. That's the first thing that you need to know. The grace will appear where there is the glory. We are in a church of the glory. The church of the glory, it means it's not the blood of Jesus. It's not, you know, Holy Spirit. The glory means God's presence. When we talk about God's presence, we talk about the appearance or the visibility of God in the place where you can go and still see God. So we are in a church where the glory is there.
Or
God is becoming visible. So that's where grace becomes our language. Things become simple. When God is there, everything becomes easy. So we are in a church where things are easy to get. But It's possible that it can be difficult even when we are in a church like that. And what makes that to be difficult is what fights the glory. Can affect the grace. Remember that the grace makes things, you know, simple. So what fight the glory can affect the grace, therefore there will be a struggle. The reason why there's a struggle is because, you know, grace has been tempered with, and the visibility of his glory has been affected. So you can understand something like that.
So,
two, I found that there's only one spirit that fight the glory. That spirit I want to talk about is called Leviathan spirit. Leviathan spirit is a spirit that fight the glory. Leviathan is there to do two things. Number one is confusion. And number two is separation. Just write it down. Number one is confusion. And number two is separation. That is Leviathan spirit. Is there to fight the glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you can still see that the glory is there. But if Leviathan is exercising his power, the grace won't be sufficient. That is why when we read Matthew 4:3, we find that when the tempter went to Jesus, he brought confusion. He said, if you are a son of God, if you are a son of God. In other words, Jesus was supposed to doubt himself if he's the one.
So,
you can still see that na Leviathan was confusing to separate Jesus from his father. I was not surprised when Jesus on the cross, he shouted and said, Father, why have thou forsaken me? It means Leviathan was in power. I don't know if you're hearing
that.
And also we have read in Isaiah 59,
verse 2,
and where Isaiah was saying, the hand of the Lord is not short, even his ear is not deaf. But because of your iniquities, in other words, it means you have been confused, and you end up being tempted to separate. So that's what happened in the church today. The reason why the church is becoming weak, we have Christians who are confused and also who are causing separation. Can you think about, you've got a pastor who's preaching the word but you don't believe in him? Automatically there's Leviathan spirit that is operating in an individual. Because Leviathan spirit doesn't go by a group. It enters someone.
Okay,
let me give you an example. When we read about, you know, Jesus saying, Judas, what you want to do, do it quickly. The Bible says, the devil enters
someone.
So you can see that it's not a spirit around. It's a spirit that enters you and manipulates you to manipulate others. So remember in the beginning I was saying, we are in a church where the glory of God is there. God is there. The visibility of God is clear. But though it's clear, you can still be affected and you affect others negatively. You find that you are in the church but you're going nowhere, or you're in the church, you are just causing confusion because you are confused too. Listen to this, people who cause confusion, they are confused. You cannot lead someone if you're not led in the right way.
So,
in the church, we have all group. But in these last days, we need to be very careful of the people who are possessed the spirit of Leviathan. That spirit is very
it
destroys them and expose them and end up putting them in destruction. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So, when you read John 9:39, that's where you hear Jesus says in Amplified Bible, I'm here as a separator to separate those who believe and unbelievers. So that's where the clarity of the people who don't believe becomes visible. You must check in your church. You find that it is easy to find out if truly you people, you are following the man of God who's filled by the Spirit. It's easy to tackle or to find out the one who's possessed. That is why by the time of Peter, it was easy for Ananias and Sapphira to fall and die. Because the Bible says they were united and led by the Spirit. I don't know if you're hearing that. So today, if you are possessed by that Spirit, you must know you won't live your life. You are being used and you are misdirected and you are there to cause division. But you need to be delivered to live your life and go back to where God has called you to do. Because God has called you to be part in the church, not to be anything that brings confusion to others. So we need to bring back the glory. We need to see that glory. We need to live the life of the glory. We need to be closer to the one who has called us to be in his house. If God is our Father, we need to see him. If not, we are still going to be confused and we will never know who's confusing us and we will question what is happening. But thank God today, because you are here. Every spirit in Charis Missionary Church that stand against that vision of the glory that brings the grace will be casted out in the name of Jesus Christ. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let me show you some scriptures. Maybe you will understand what I'm trying to teach you, because I'm trying to teach you here. If you read Isaiah 27:1, just go there. You'll find that spirit. Isaiah 27:1. Can I read? In that day, the Lord, with his sword and great and strong sword, shall punish Leviathan, the piercing serpent, even Leviathan, the crooked serpent, and he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea.
Motlawo morena o tlo tla kwena golo noga ya lebilo le kwena golo noga ya go mme nagana o tlo bolaya mamokope wa lewatle ka le romolawe le letleleng le legolo le le matla.
Let me read in Amplified Bible so that you understand. In that day, I mean today, the Lord will deliver Charis
amen
from her enemies.
Amen.
You saw the verse there. In that day, the Lord will deliver Charis from the enemies and also from the rebel powers of evil and darkness.
Amen.
His sharp and unrelated, great and strong sword will visit and punish Leviathan, the shiftly fleeing spirit.
Amen.
Leviathan, the twisting and the winding serpent, and he will slay the monster that is in the sea.
Amen.
So you can see that here, Leviathan spirit is from the sea. You can see that. And there are three things there
that has been
the description of Leviathan spirit. Number one, as you can see, it's called fleeing serpent. Number one, twisting serpent and the monster.
Amen.
Can you see? Those three things.
So
it means ugly. Once you are vulnerable to it, you are affected in a very bad way. It's a monster. You're in a church where you don't believe your pastor. You are affected by a monster.
It's
a very bad way. Okay, look here. I have learned something. If you can read, those who read, you can understand that
Leviathan
is the spirit of a crocodile. In other words, it moves slowly. And then once it overpowers you, you can't do anything. But when it comes to you, it moves like a crocodile. When we talk about crocodile, we talk about protocol. Because crocodile cannot move without a protocol.
So
there's a way it moves. So when you open up, it moves. When you open up, it moves. And it comes slowly. But once it grabs you, you will never fight and conquer. That is why it's very hard. That's what Peter said. He said it's very hard after you have tested the glory and you repent again. Because already you have been gripped. And this is the monster will never play with you, will destroy you. And you know, this is happening in the church where we have got Christians, all of them, we think they are filled by the Holy Spirit. And you find there's another one who's already opened for the monster. And it moves in a protocol. When you open the door and accept that it must move there, it just destroys you in an amazing way. You know, this thing is just reminding me one time when I found that I had Christians who didn't even believe in what I'm doing. And they began to say, truly, we see the power of God. But this guy, they call me the guy. They call me guy.
If this guy,
think about, you know, you've got Christians who call you the guy. Why? Because already they've been gripped by the monster and affected. Even their perspective has been affected. How they think a defeat. Already they're already divorcing the vision. They're in the church, but they're not part of the church. Because already they have been gripped. Think about you, a Christian in the church where pastor is preaching, but you are just there to oppose. You're just there to say, what is he talking about? What is happening? Because the moment you are possessed, you are gripped. And to come out from there, you need the hand of God again. So, the Bible says God will fight for
charis.
I prophesy you. God is fighting for
charis.
That's what my friend. There's power to grip. But we are escaping. Because we are born to live our life in charis and moved by the grace. And nothing can stop us because we are called not to struggle. We are called to live our life without fear. We are Christians who knows that things happen swiftly without struggle, and no one can oppose us and overcome us. Because we know the end. Whoever is in charis, who sees the glory,
eh?
Who have overcome Leviathan spirit, he can see pain, but he can also see the glory. He can see sorrow, but he can see the glory. He understands that I'm a
passing here. I'm not dying here. I'm passing here because of the glory that God has set for me. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what's my friend. You can't destroy me. You can't separate me. You can't. Because listen, whoever has been
affected,
you know, the person you've got conflict. There are minds that have been established all the time to cancel even the word of God that is entering there. Leviathan spirit is very dangerous. Tell a neighbor, Leviathan spirit is very dangerous. Because one day, because I'll talk about what I've experienced. Long time ago, I saw one Christian I was having. When I was having a church there, attacked by Leviathan spirit. When we are worshipping, lifting up the hands, the person will do like this. And the person thinks he's doing that for me. Because he's here to cause separation. Others end up being exposed and talk. Because you know you're in the presence of God. Where people who are not serious must be exposed. So that their unseriousness must be visible in the church. And many will run away from your church. They will run away from your company. Because you don't need wrong people. You need right people. I know Gideon. When God was saying, go and overcome. He look at the number and goes ahead. Don't look at the number. Even in charis, because of the grace, we don't go by the number. We go by the grace of God because the glory of God is upon our lives. Hey, we don't care whether you leave the church. We don't care. We don't care with your spirit. We know he who's unto us is bigger than the one unto the world. So we are not afraid of what devil can do. If you believe, shout hallelujah. In charis, we cannot be shaken. We cannot. Because we know the spirit that is fill us. He always tells us about the promises are coming and they are sure. I look poor but there is something coming. I look defeated but I'm an overcomer. We need Christians who understand that they cannot be judged by what they are facing. When you overcome the vital spirit, even if you are recruited, you can laugh at the recruiter because you know the one who put you in the house of the living God is the one who knows your name. He has called you because he knows your name. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
I'm here to tell you these things. You think I'm a pastor who's playing?
Because I've seen the spirits that possess people.
Leviathan
spirit is in the sea, but it can see what is happening in the church. Because listen to this, it's as good as submarine that can shoot towards the land, but still hiding. Because you ever fight you when he's hiding, he's telling you that he's afraid of you, but you cannot be defeated by the one who's hiding from you. So any spirit that is hiding to you is nothing.
Arise.
Because when we read here, we hear the Lord will deliver
charis
from enemies and from rebel powers. You know, there are some rebel powers. And there are three things we spoke about, Mosta, Also, there's a twisting serpent.
We also read about twisting serpent.
In other words, this misinterpretation. Can you see now? I'm saying, receive Jesus. What is he talking about? When I say, you are blessed. Can you think about, we are in a church where we say, can we get that money, we buy instruments. And you find those who are possessed by levitation. You want to eat our money. Because already, everything must be twisted. It's a twisting serpent. It always twists. Whatever we say in the church, to fight Satan, it must be twisted. The moment when we say we want to do this in the church, the twisting spirit will twist the mind and bring some kind of an explanation that brings tiredness. So, usually we find churches like that where you find that everybody do whatever he wish. And that is not the format of God. God from the beginning, he will choose Moses. When Moses is dead, he bring Joshua. Just like that. So, but now, whoever is holding a vision is the one that must be followed. But the twisting spirit will always try to bring opposition so that those who have been overcome by Leviathan spirit, whatever they do, they want to be seen so that they get some groups that will control in the church. And that is why the spirit of the living God will never stand with them. Listen to the spirit of the living God want unity, want, you know, hope together, togetherness, want corporate anointing, corporate worship. The spirit of the living God wants togetherness. In our church here, I see people who are coming together, doing things together. It's easy to spot the one who's wrong. It's so easy. Even if I can't talk about it, you won't face me 3 days. Because you know the spirit that has possessed, you will know that there has to be a repelling spirit. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen to this. There is something that God is going to do for you. Because God has brought you to church to serve him. If there's any spirit from your friend that will rise to destroy the plan of God, that you need to be part of it, or to partake on it, or to execute it, you will find that spirit and that person will run away from you. Because there are some people that devil is using to stop you in your progress so that you won't hear God. I don't know if you're hearing me. If we can be in a church, when we want to do something, we do it, we are going to overcome. I don't know if you're hearing me. Just look at these verses as we are about to close. Maybe if we talk about this, you will understand the spirit now that has possessed. Can you ask your neighbor, are you not far from Leviathan? Or sometimes you cover Leviathan to become your friend. So you understand that God will punish that spirit. If you read 1 Corinthians 14:33, it says God is not the author of confusion. Remember, God has not brought confusion. If God make you give you a leader, it's not confusion. Obey your leader. Hear what he says, you will prosper. If you read Genesis, I want to show you something. How you can overcome Leviathan spirit. Can I tell you? In Genesis 3, from verse 1 to 6, if you can read there, you realize that, you know, Satan was trying to bring confusion and say, I don't think you heard God. Yeah. Because he was saying,
do you think is what God is saying? Is it exactly what God is saying? He was bringing a confusion. He said, no, no, no. God is not talking about that. No, you can still eat this tree. And you know, he was addressed as a crafty serpent, which is the same spirit from the sea. Listen to this. If you want to find where Satan is, you'll find that is in the sea. So you can still see here, coming up here and come like a snake and begin to say, do you think God is exactly saying what he's saying? So that is the first thing that you need to check. What you need to check there, whoever is around you, you must discern the spirit. If you want to overcome the spirit of Leviathan, discern. Don't just take anything that person is saying. You know, can I give an example? Do you think you are in a church? When you are in a church, somebody can come and tell you, your pastor is not good. The person is not attending your church. How does that person know your pastor? Okay, you are in a church where somebody could say, you know, no, this church here, man, this church, man, this pastor. Automatically, you know this person is possessed. In the church, we are not there to talk about the pastor. We are not going to talk about the... We are there to talk about Jesus. You can ask the person and say, when are we going to talk about Jesus? Because now you are talking about this chair. You know this chair. You need to ask a question and say, hey, tell us, when are we going to talk about Jesus? We are talking about this chair. If the pastor maybe can get money, this pastor must be supported by you. So he must get money and eat money. So when are we going to talk about Jesus and us supporting our pastor? So the issue of why pastor is to make sure that when it's time to support, you withdraw. So you can see that your action of faith can be affected if you won't discern the spirit. So when you want to be in fullness of doing what God wants you to do, you will withdraw because you know that there's some stories attached. So we need Christians who are saying, I'm not here for stories, I'm here for my God. So such Christians will prosper. Listen to this. You must check from now to June next year. If you are holding your church, holding your pastor, don't look your pastor by education or ability or what. Your pastor must always be your pastor. When you're in your church, you stay there and say, I'm going to worship and whatever he tells me I will do, I'm giving you only 6 months. You are going to be a pillar in the house of the living God. I don't know if you're hearing me. People will admire you. I said they will admire you. I command the spirit of Leviathan to leave this church today. Whoever is opposing in chalice, get out in the mighty name of Jesus. Leave the house. You have got no way, and you have got no space, and you don't have the smell to breathe together. Get out with your spirit. We need Christians who can discern such people. Can you let me speak in Xhosa?
Eh?
Because there are Xhosas here. Yeah? Wandiva. Wandiva.
Are you hearing? Are you hearing me?
Ngiyakucelela. Wandiva.
I am telling you.
Are
you hearing me?
Arre! Ikona indaba lapha.
There is an issue here.
Mina ngiyakucela.
And I'm telling you.
Ngithi ngokuba
because
ukona la.
You are here in this place.
Ngahambe.
They must go.
Ngithingakahambe.
They must leave.
Ngithingakahambe.
Let them leave.
Ngithingakahambe.
Let them leave.
Ahamba.
Let them leave.
Asifuni la.
We don't want you in this place.
We don't want people that will dilute us.
Baba tari dilute us to melo. Kale bakalo rena ra dilute.
We don't want stupid people. Who don't know where they are coming. Why they are coming in the church. We know where God took us. We know where we come from. 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 When God took us, where were you? We are from zero to something. We are from nothing to something. So, hey! Abba! Asinandaba now.
I am not tabali wena. We don't care about you.
Asinandaba.
We don't care. We are telling you.
Because some people, they are there to give us tough times. Even Moses, the Bible says, he was affected by the people. To extend that one day, what he was supposed to hear God, and he ended up beating the stone. And this affected his promise. He failed to go to Canaan because of the people. This is the right time that we cannot back the people. We follow Jesus and we don't mind what the people are saying. Amba! Amba, wena! Amba to your father! Can you tell somebody, hey, go to your father! We know our father. Go to your father. We know our father. You are in a wrong address. Amba. Can you shake somebody's
head?
If you are not
situated, if you are not situated,
if
this bed is so hot for you,
Amba.
Hey, go.
Yeah! Yeah, well, oh! Salapas.
Dula fast.
Ngizontele.
I'll tell you.
Ngizontele la. Ngizile apha
unikele. I'm here to tell you.
Because
we know Charis. It's not coming from somebody. Charis is coming from heaven. Our Father.
So
our God knows us that we are here in Tepisa, and we know this thing that we are talking about.
I'll
tell you.
Arrays. If you read 1 John,
chapter 2,
from verse 18. 1 John,
Johanna Wapili.
You will love this verse. Chapter 2, verse 18. Boys, lads, it is the last time or hour, the end of this age. And as you have heard that the Antichrist, he who opposed Christ, is the geese of Christ is coming. Even now, many antichrists have risen, which confirms our beliefs that it is the final, the end time. They went out from our number.
Amen.
Can you see the verse 19? They went out from where? But they did not belong to us.
Mm.
For if they had been of us,
mm.
they would have remained with us.
Mm.
But they withdraw that it might be plain that they all are not of us.
Amen. Banabaka, kinako ya bofelo go mejwalo. Ka ge le kwile gore go etla molwantsha Kriste. Mehleng yeno go tsogile ba lwa le Kriste ba bantsi. Ke sona se re bona go ka sona ge e le nako ya bofelo. Ba tshwile mo gore ina fela e be ise ba rena. Ge e ka be ile ba rena, ba ka be ba duchi ba na le rena fela. Ke gore ba bonagale ge e se ba rena ka moka ga bona.
Yeah, it's, if you can read there, you realize Antichrist.
How come I'm not telling more about the Christ?
It's not somebody that will be born as Antichrist.
As much as what I tell you, Mariki, I'm not the Christ.
It's the one that has been defeated by Leviathan spirit.
Yeah, now, okay, much we are shooting. Come on, Leviathan.
Leviathan, when he defeats you,
Mayao, how come you lie?
You oppose the body of Christ.
I'm not the Christ. I'm not talking
with you. You are Antichrist because the church is the body of Christ.
I'm the Christ.
Are you hearing that? So you begin to oppose. Think about you in a church where you're just opposing. You're wasting your time. Because here, John says, if they were with us, they were supposed to have continued. In other words, for us to overcome Leviathan spirit is to continue. We need to continue. When it's tough, we continue. When it's raining, we continue. When it's dark, we continue. I've learned something. This church started very small. But it was very, very hard. One time it was raining. When God began to show me things, it was raining. Two people came to church. In that church, they came two. When I was standing there, God began to speak with me. He said, don't look at the number. Look at that one. When I look at the brother, God gave me words. And he said, tell that brother, he must not go home. And the brother said, yes, I'm going home tomorrow. And I heard God say, if you go home, he will never come back to Gauteng. He went home. And then he didn't even listen. It was only two people. It was raining. And I was standing, but God spoke. God does not look at the number of the people we are having in the church. As long as there's tough times that we are facing, but those tough times does not drop us down, we continue. We need Christians who can say, I can see it's tough. I'm continuing. I can see I'm failing to pray. But I'll carry on praying. I'm continuing. I'm seeing myself is so tough. There is no way that I can achieve. But my God is on my side. To overcome that spirit, do not be tired. Bible says those who trust in the Lord, their strength shall be renewed, and they shall run, and they will never be worried. Even you must continue. Continue in giving, continue in praying, continue in praising, continue in fasting. Sometimes when you look around, the situation dictates for you. When you look around, you even ask yourself, am I really called to be in this church? Am I really called to be a child of God? Why people are not saved? Are moving forward? My friend, on that tough time, God is opening the door for you. Continue. Tell someone, say, hey, continue when it's tough. Continue.
when they are opposing you, continue. Continue. Can I tell you? This is the best formula in
charis.
If Christians want to prosper in
charis,
carry on. Sometimes your finances are speaking against you. Debts are everywhere. Carry on. Tell yourself, I can't stop because of what I'm facing. Sometimes you are in a fasting. The devil says, stop, carry on. Don't listen to Satan because you are closer to your breakthrough. Let me prophesy. If you are going to continue to do what God wants you to do, the grace and the mercy of God will fall upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Because if you don't continue, Leviathan spirit will bring confusion. Pastor, do you think God has called you? Do business.
Dear business.
Just do business. Also.
Oh, no, business.
That business,
business
will keep you away from the work of God. No one who's big was not small. What did Job say? Though your beginning will be small, your latter end will flourish. Can I prophesy you? Can I prophesy you? You are growing to a level where you become pillar in the church. This is the right time now that you get out from people. It's the right time now. You get out from people and you say, I have come to church alone. I have come alone.
No,
to church alone.
No.
I have come alone.
No, hey, no,
to serve my God.
I'm
not here to stand against anybody. As long as my leader is there,
as long as
who's my pastor, I will obey him. I have come alone. It's better I become stupid for a while than to be stupid forever. I have come alone. We're talking about continuing. If we read Genesis 11,
1 to 9,
they were confused because they speak one language. They forget the mind of God. In other words, confusion came when I've got this friend. Like we are talking one language. But I could not hear what God is saying. I remember when I told my pastor, I said, yes, you are there, but be careful of somebody that will come and support you. Tomorrow he rules you. We need a person who will come and sit in the church. If you understand the vision of the church. Not a person who will say, I'll help you. As if you are stranded. I don't know if you're hearing me. So where we have read, you need to understand the language. Not all people who speak your language are very good for you. They can bring confusion. I don't know if you're hearing me. In Nehemiah 4,
verse 7 to 8,
the Bible says, when they heard that they went forward building, that's how they conspire together against them. In
Nehemiah 4,
Verse 7 to 8. When they heard that there's a progress of building, they conspire together to confuse so that they will stop the work. Can I say this to you? Your enemy, he looks at your moving forward. Once you move forward, they come together against you.
so that they can confuse whatever you are doing, so that you'll be able to stop. It might be in your job or in your business, in your ministry or whatever. Enemies will be there.
There
are conspiracies. It's for stopping you on what you are doing. Listen to this. Once there's a progress, there is an enemy. Once you progress, the enemy will rise. Will just rise to stop you. There are some people here that they saw the stop signs. But I want to tell you, those stop signs are not there for cul-de-sac. Accelerate. Move forward. They want to stop you. Don't stop. Move forward. When you move forward, you are confusing your enemies. Your enemies want to stop your progress. They want to stop your life. They are coming together with a Leviathan spirit. Don't fear. Carry on. Move forward. Don't stop. They can come together. But when you stand with your God, they will run 7 ways. They will be against you, but they will be defeated. You will see them, but they won't conquer. I'm here to prophesy you in this conference. I don't know who's making conspiracy against you, but I'm here to tell you, whoever that is against you will never stop your vision, will never stop your life, your business, your progress, in the name of Jesus. Whatever you want to do, I say press on. I say press on. In your business, I say press on. In your church, press on. In what you are doing, press on. Don't look back. You are not called to look back. You are called to look forward. Press on. There's a crown in front of you. Press on to your destiny. Press on to what you're doing. Press on and take the crown that God has set before you. I prophesy you. I say, hey, press on. Any conspiracy against your education, against your career, against your marriage, against your life, I'm here to tell you that conspiracy is destroying its honor. As I prophesy you, my God is exposing that conspiracy in the name above all names, in the name of Jesus. They are fighting you underground, but my God is exposing them. They are fighting your career, but my God is exposing them. They will see promotion. They will see your promotion. They are fighting you, but I'm here to tell you, my God is exposing them. In your family, they don't understand you. There's a conspiracy. Your friends, they don't understand you. There's a conspiracy. The co-pastors, they don't understand you. There's a conspiracy. Your family, your relatives, they don't understand you. There's a conspiracy. I'm here when I come in the name of Jesus. I say, I confuse them. I confuse them. I confuse them.
I confuse them. I confuse them. I confuse them. I confuse them. I confuse them. Today, you are taking what belongs to you. Today, you are taking what God has given you. I confuse them. 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 In your job, I confuse them. In your business, I confuse them. I say, hey, I confuse them. Those who are against your vision. I say, hey, you won't stop. You won't stop. My God is confusing them. Whatever they wish for you to be is what they are becoming to be. And you are becoming their leader. I say, hey, your enemies, I see them. They are confused right now. Where you are working, they are confused right now. I say, hey, those who are fighting your ministry, they are confused right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Tell some people.
Which
are my enemies? Are confused. Tell seven people.
Which are my seven?
Say they are confused. Say they are confused.
Hey, batakataka.
They are confused.
Batakataka.
And I'm taking.
Nakia chia.
I'm taking my car.
Chia telling chaka koloyaka.
I'm taking my house.
Kichan toyaka.
I'm taking my car.
Nakicha koloyaka.
I'm taking my house.
Nakichan toyaka.
I'm taking my life.
Hey, kicha koloyaka.
I'm taking.
Kia chia.
What belongs to me?
Kichan telling chaka.
I'm taking.
Kia chia.
What I'm here for?
Tote nakita chingchon.
I'm taking.
Hey, kia chia.
I'm taking.
Kia.
I'm taking my healing. I'm taking my progress. I'm taking my promotion. I'm taking. I'm taking what belongs to me. I'm taking my anointing. I'm taking my house. I'm taking my job. I'm taking my life. I'm taking.
What
are you taking? What are you taking? What are you taking? What are you taking? What are you taking? What are you taking?
When out here,
what are you taking?
When out here,
what are you taking?
When out here,
what are you taking?
Uchia wana khosh.
What are you taking?
Uchia ingi.
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 I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Uchia ndoi
ingi. What are you taking?
Uchia ingi wana khosh. Uchia ingi.
Yeah.
Yeah, rabas.
Oh.
Hey.
Oh, Jesus. My brother, you as a pastor, come. You are here to take your anointing. Take it. Yo, even this one, come. The taller one. Even you, God is anointing you because of the opposers. God, listen to me. My God says there are opposers who want you to fall down. They are against you. But I see my God say, tell this man, because I'm hearing a name called Mathangu.
Mahlangu.
There's a group of Mahlangus.
Ona le group ya Mahlangu.
There's a person called Pastor Mahlangu.
Ona le motho sho maruti
Mahlangu. I'm here to tell you.
Ere ke le botse ngwana
go. All the groups of the pastors.
Di group tse ka ofela tsa baruti le
baruti.
Ba leng khatana o le lena.
They are falling down.
Ba ya wana
jwale. In the name of Jesus.
Ka le bitso la Jesus.
I'm seeing the glory. I see pastor from
Zambia.
God is anointing you. Come here. Check it. You're anointed. I saw some people that are here. And God said, come, my sister, you. This lady, come. Yes. Come, you. Come here, come. God is establishing you.
As,
you know why God is establishing you?
Eh?
Eh? Because of your heart for the ministry. Listen. There are stories you heard.
It's
not true.
It's true.
There are stories you heard concerning the ministry.
Ministry.
So that the ministry will divide.
Or ministry divide.
But I'm here, I'm listening to this. Don't listen to this person. Because God is raising you in the ministry because of your heart. Because of your heart. I'm hearing a name called
Andile.
Andile. This person called Andile. Are you married? Eh? So you don't know Andile? Andile is coming.
Andile,
I'm here to tell you about
Andile.
And the marriage is coming in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I saw anointing falling. And I was asking myself, what is happening? And God said, okay, I will anoint this man. And then he will change everybody's mind. Brother, I can tell you where God took you there. It's just a preparation. God is just preparing you for the ministry.
Amen.
It's so close, I think I'll speak with you, with your pastor.
Yes.
I see God anointing you. Come to me. Because today is your day of anointing.
Amen.
You're free. There's a lady that I'm seeing now at the back there. That doctor told you about the side of, on a side, on an ovaries. There's a cyst there. There, I believe this lady is coming from Botswana. You know her? You know her, Mama? You know her?
Taboka Bachoni.
Eh?
Taboka Bachoni. That's her name.
Please, can you run? Because I'm seeing you. Sis. I don't know you.
Karakutsi.
She told you, Mama.
Bali Udiche.
Not this one. There is one called Taboka Bachoni.
She's the one. Yeah. Is this one?
She even went for.
Is this spend. One?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the one that I'm talking about. But there's a demon in here. Well, you know, this issue of the chu.
Tabachecha di chu.
And the cyst that is sitting
Le,
here. It's caused by demon.
There's
a demon that is sitting there.
I even
told, advised her to come here today so that he can get her deliverance.
What are you doing in a stomach there? Can you speak? What are you doing? Why are you blocking the womb? Can you see what is happening? The whole place is electrified.
Amen.
Many people can still fall when they.
Yeah.
So, what are you doing in life?
When I would run more,
can you come here, you? Because you also have a problem. But yours is not witchcraft. This is just a normal issue that can happen. It's not only you.
As when I let you.
Because I see some people in the family, they also have this problem.
Eh?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Can you bring that one? We've got a demo. I destroy you.
Amen.
Come on. Come on. That one I prayed for. Where is she?
She can
even check herself. She's also healed. Even this one, she's delivered. Leave her. Just leave her. Leave her. Leave her to do what she's doing. How do you feel?
I feel okay because when I was on the bus, I was having a pain.
Pain
was disturbing me.
And then
I'm
swaying.
So now I can't feel the pain.
Thank you, Jesus.
That lady that was saying she can't feel the pain. There's a dream she has dreamed. And this dream is like she always see a man coming to sleep with
her. He's
true man of God.
And this man is the one that is, affecting generation. It's not only you, it's like it happens to your mom. I'm seeing somebody who died.
Yes, my grandmother.
Eh?
My grandmother died 2 months back.
And now, your mom wants to die now. Because I'm seeing your mom being sick.
Yes, man of God. And
then
she's not feeling very well.
Eh?
She's not well now.
Listen,
you are coming from where?
From Botswana.
So you are coming here for the first time?
No, it's my second time. So I
came
here last year.
You came last year?
Yes.
But what I'm telling you is a new thing to you.
Yes,
because I'm talking about something of 3 months ago.
Yes, it's true, man of God. My grandmother passed away in September. It's true. It's very true.
Is it not 3 months ago?
Yeah, it's 3 months ago.
Now, that's how your mom now started to be sick.
Yes.
And they want to kill mama on February.
And they want to
deliver our family, men of God.
No, God has already delivered.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Remember what I'm trying to tell you.
It happens
to your mom. Let's get out of that. It just happened.
It's over.
I don't want to waste time. Because I saw this lady and... Can you come here, my sister? Yes. God loves you.
Amen.
I said, God loves you.
Amen.
Amen.
Where do you come from?
Flora, Mulechi.
Where do you come from?
Mulechi, Flora.
Mulechi. Litswakai.
Mulechi.
Mulechi.
She needs deliverance, Pastor.
Litlokolokolo.
This lady needs deliverance. There are some witches.
Onalevalui.
Who are using a figure. Always people are rejecting her.
But Mohana.
They don't want her. You know what I'm talking about?
Why it's even doing?
There's too much rejection around you.
Yes.
Because of the people that are dreaming you. Even yourself, yeah. You need deliverance, my sister. Because I'm standing here. I'm seeing a snake, a very big snake. And you always dream a snake.
I used to see it.
Huh?
I used to see it, even if I'm not sleeping.
So,
a snake.
No.
Can you follow me?
Come here.
According to me, this lady, she's a snake.
I was supposed
to come and say, you're a snake. Because, can you see, when she sleeps, she sees a snake. And she said, even when she's sitting. Can you see what she's doing? It's a snake. Even what she's doing. Now she's pointing the
pastor. You want to kill this one.
Can you show me, you want to kill who?
Yes, this one. Who?
Why?
He's disturbing us.
We are disturbed.
Clap hands for that pastor. All pastors of Charis, they disturb.
But Charis,
all pastors of
They disturb witches. All of them. You people must trust your pastor now. You
hear
me? You must trust your pastor. All pastors are disturbing.
All right.
You leave her. Why are you saying he's troubling you?
He planted a church in the house of this person. I'm entering in here.
Yes.
I just want to kill her also. Yes.
Arrest.
I just had to kill
you. You see, no?
That is keeping us. There's no church there. It destroys everything. They are taking our people. They are killing our things.
Arrest.
That
you can hear.
I hate. I hate her also.
The moment there is a church of charis, there is something like a smoke on top
where
the
church
is, which is the glory. No witch can fly on top. Listen to this, it's not only her. There are many people here who have been attacked by witches. And some of you, since you run to church, witches can operate. Wizards can operate. So you are troubling them.
Yeah, where are you coming from, you Makanani?
When I'm Makanani, say Luru Chaka.
Plant many churches.
Yes, you disturb us, man. We are a
disturb.
You
disturb
us. We are a disturb.
So,
yes, Mahabi.
You know why God wants you to hear that? Is God want you to hear this?
Watch another
one.
Why are you speaking another about one?
Don't
make us to be angry. You are starting it. We don't want these people here. We don't want them. In December, they are planning to go there to that pastor. We don't want them.
Watch.
We don't want them.
Watch. Another one.
Don't make me crazy. Don't speak about Mulich.
Look at another one here. Let's listen to this one.
Where are you? I'm searching for you.
Eh?
Where are you? I'm searching for you. Where are you? Where are you?
Sit down.
Do la fast.
It's fighting. Did that say fire?
Oh.
I never say fire, but can you see? Sometimes God can do his things.
So what are you doing? You are
fighting.
So get a hold of you. When I catch you, you will regret seriously. I'll get you. And
all right, leave her. Let her come and touch me. Leave
her.
Come.
Hey,
come. Stop talking.
To a plano. You are getting used to me.
I'm coming. Okay.
I want to hold you.
No, you are lost.
I'm coming. I know how I come. I'm still coming.
Okay.
Sit down.
You are enjoying yourself.
You are defeated. Sit
down.
You are defeated.
Amen.
There are some people here. In my heart, I felt that after this conference here, this conference will change the whole charis.
It will change the charis.
Because, listen, people that don't know what God has given them. You find that
You have a pastor, but you don't trust your pastor. And I want to tell you now, God has raised, these pastors for you people. Never undermine your pastors. There's a lady called Lucy. Lucy, come. Lucy, come. Don't sit down, come. Lucy. I'm just hearing Lucy, come, come. Where is Lucy? Lucy. L-U-C-Y.
L-U-C-Y.
Yes. Yeah, this is the one. Watch, watch, watch. Watch what is happening to her. God told me that this lady does not sleep. She's struggling a lot.
Oh, I sokola haholo.
So, because of this spirit, this spirit must leave you. Leave her.
Sipila.
I said, leave her.
Sipila.
Huh? What are you doing in
there? I wanted to suffer.
Why you don't want to sleep? I can't hear you.
What is she supposed to do in life?
Where is this lady come from?
Okay.
Listen to. So this lady can't sleep. They tried to attack her. And then she tried to sleep. These demons are tormenting her. Why are you tormenting her?
Why
are
you tormenting
her?
I just wanted to suffer.
Let me touch your head. I want to touch your head there. I'm touching your head.
Amen.
I cut that head.
Amen.
You are defeated in Jesus' Amen. Mighty name. Leave it. Come on. She's free from tonight. She will be able to sleep. I saw this. Can I come to you? I saw this one.
Satan, I'm going to show you something about.
Too much. I'm seeing all your children pregnant. They'll be pregnant. You know, it's like devil wants just to make you suffer.
Satan
you
know? Going to tell tambure.
Huh?
Only one left. All of them.
That's what I'm saying. So they want to make you suffer. Where are those children? They are all at home. He says it's only one left.
She said only one. Dibangana
barnaban.
Four of them have got children.
Devil wants to is enjoying to make that
Satan go takazango it as an
and then this is making many suffering children.
Here's a quota tambuling a man.
But I want to pray for all of them. That they get men who can marry
them.
Receive. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you. You are blessed. Because your case is, when I'm looking at it, I'm not happy.
I can level at
the person who did this.
Give one more to a dear link to say. And mama rata motho kuduka matla.
Just like a black old lady who's doing this.
Mama mongwe monso.
Rise up, mama.
Ka bata koe.
God loves you, you are free.
Unse mo ba funa bo bo fro.
God heard your prayer because you were asking why, you know, in your family the people can't marry.
Nele pushoro why la peng batho sa nyana.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I'm talking about.
So God is doing it right now.
Somebody more idea, Anna Joanne. Thank you.
So
Is it which one? Come, brother.
It's a papa.
You come.
It's a.
Where do you come from?
It's okay.
I'm coming from Sitom.
Huh?
From Sitom.
I saw you need to pray. Eh?
It's a quarter pen.
Otherwise, you are going to be diabetic.
How's your little diabetes?
You hear me?
Yes.
You need to pray this.
It's a quarter pen.
You are starting to be affected by me.
Got a little more affected. I'm more fast.
I often hear some pains. I often hear some pains.
Okay, what is the pain in my timing at?
Yes, I'm seeing this thing here. And it, you are becoming very weak.
And a little more about weak, I won't.
This is a diabetes issue.
Get away from diabetes.
It's a disease that keeps people in
the family. Give away from the doctor.
When they go to the doctor, the doctor will say it's a high blood.
Ah, I have doctor and doctor will get blood. Tabay, get away serious. Namaste. Le fodi.
I'm taking pills for her blood.
Listen to him. Listen to this. You say what?
I'm taking pills for high blood.
Can what the pills for high blood? Can take
it
well enough.
When you go, people, all of them say high blood.
I high blood.
This diabetes that killing.
One only diabetes if it's aging.
You're not supposed to be taking those pills.
I want to encourage
you to go for a test.
You
realize this is a spiritual issue.
Let alone more and take into a small.
You are free.
Let look little papa.
Receive your favor. Receive.
I receive.
Receive your heart desire.
I receive.
Receive what you are here for.
I receive.
I saw you. And I was asking myself, you are here. And God says,
you put your room.
Yes, come. You're a prophet.
The prophet.
Listen, I'll tell you why I say a prophet.
Because
after I prayed for you,
amen.
After I prayed for you, doubt. And what you're going to see now is going to be a real thing, because the things of leaving your body, going where, to heaven, it will stop for now. God wants to show you things that is happening on people.
Amen.
Amen. Because after I pray for you, you are doubting. You doubted, and you just believe you need somebody like me, spiritual father. And but God says to me, I must tell you,
amen.
You're a prophet.
The prophet. Amen.
This man is a prophet. I'm sure you remember this man, Mavane. Mavane. I'm sure you remember him.
Yes, Papa.
This man is a prophet.
Amen.
Utiba Papa waki prophet.
You are not. Can you just come here, my brother, the short man? Where's your wife?
Mama, okay.
Come with your wife. Is this one your wife?
Kim Sadialina.
Yes.
I'm sorry to ask you that question.
I'm
seeing many things that this lady, she's complaining, questioning why things are like this. This man is called, but short temper. It's not true.
It's true.
I can't hear.
Sorry.
I can't hear you.
It's true, prophet.
Men of God.
This lady, she's doubting your calling.
Mama, it's
true, man of God. It's true, man of God.
Because of your character.
It's true, man of God.
Your character is shocking.
It's true, man of God. Many mess up in the church.
Yeah?
It's true, man.
Why are you stopping here?
Sorry, David. I want to hear what you say.
No, what I'm saying is final.
Take it with a long
privilege. It's true.
Is it true what I'm saying?
Yes, it's true.
You have got short temper. People are going because of
yes.
Sometimes it's like he's cursing them.
Yes, man of God, it's true.
It's like
is a boss there. Of
yes, man of God. It's true. It's true, man of God.
So
it's true.
You are looking, is he called? Why is he doing like this?
Are
you coming here for the first time?
First time. It's
the
first time.
From where?
Swaziland.
You need a speaker for
because
your temper. Devil is using it to destroy your church. The church that you suffer for so much.
Amen.
For this lady, she's very good for you.
Mama,
but do you know that this lady sometimes she think about leaving you?
Jesus.
It's true, man of God.
Why? Why she think about leaving you?
There are many things happened to me.
Many things happened to the church, man of God.
Don't leave him. He needs deliverance.
Many things.
He just needs deliverance. And from after that, he's going to be
free.
Must forgive him.
Amen.
Can you see? Look at him. You need deliverance. You are free, eh?
Look, Lori.
You are free too.
Amen.
You must pray. Run to me. You must pray. But yes, you must pray.
Listen to rappel.
When I say you must pray, because there's this thing that is coming upon you. There's the Holy Spirit upon you. Can you run, Mama? Yes, run. Mama Sume, come here for healing. You are healed.
Amen.
You are healed, yeah. You are healed, Mama. You are healed. God loves you. You must not worry again. Can you just come, Pastor? You are anointed.
Little rich.
Can you just receive anointing? Take it. Follow your husband. Can you just come here? Follow. Can you come here? Even you follow. Follow, come here. Follow there. Go. In Jesus' name. Even you follow. Come. Follow too. So all of you, follow. All of you here, follow. Follow. Can you come, brother? Come on, UK. Come on, take it. UK. Uh-huh. All of you, take it there. Take the power. Take. All of you, take. All of you, pastors, receive. Take. All of you here, take. You at the back, take. At the back there, receive. Congratulations, all of you. Thank you.
Amen.
There's the glory of God in this place.
Amen.
So the grace is upon us. You have the grace.
Amen.
Say, I have the grace.
I have the grace.
Say, I have the grace.
I have the grace.
Listen to this. I wanted to take a long time. We dance together so that some things must fall in. Listen, when you celebrate the annual conference next year,
annual conference,
you'll be having your car, your house,
yeah.
Listen, you must see them now. I'm seeing something. That's why you see me dancing.
That's why
when shy. Look at my dance.
Thank you. God bless you.